Hello friends, I am Marco and in this video I am going to show you how to make any type of counter circuits very easily with the help of microcontroller. In this video, the microcontroller which I will be using is Arduino. This Arduino can be Arduino Uno or Nano or Mega or anything you can use, but that must be an Arduino. All the components which you will be required for making the circuit is now on your screen. Besides this, you need a computer or laptop where you have to install a program named Arduino IDE, and by that program you have to upload a program to the Arduino board. That Arduino program I am going to show you after a few minutes. So now if you have seen all the components on the board, let's move on to see the Arduino programs which you will have to upload on the Arduino board to get the result. So now let's quickly have a look at the Arduino programs. So now let's try connecting all the components on the board. Now before I start, I have connected my LED display and the LED display driver on my display module, and you have to do that before you start. So now I have to start with my Arduino Nano. Here I have now this Arduino Nano I will be using, and here is my D2, then it is D3, then it is D4, then it is D5. If you look it carefully, you will see like this, that where is D2, D3, then D4, then D5. I have shown it to you now, and if you carefully look at the Arduino program carefully. Okay, now I think it's now properly working. There are some problems of my camera. Now if you carefully look, that here is the D2, then D3, then D4, then D5. I have made D2 as A, D3 as B, then D4 as C, now D5 as D. If we have to connect the these terminals to the display driver in reverse, that is, we have to connect the A to D, then B to C, then C to B, and then D to A in this way to get our result. So at first I must say that here you can see all these three are in serial. So now I will be removing the Arduino and let's make the connection. Now I will be connecting so that it becomes easier for me to make all the connections for the 7-segment LED display. Now here I will make the connection for D2, which will become my A. Now I have made this line as D, and it will be D for my display module. And then I have to connect the C, which is actually B, now it's B connected. Now let's connect the C. And now it's all right. I have connected all the parts, and now I will be connecting the Arduino. Now let's match it with the D, and we have to connect the D2 to the D2. So I have to connect with this pin. Connect it properly. Then if it is D2, you have to connect this pin.
So now it's my perfect connection, and now let's put pressure and make it tight. Yeah, it is now tighted, and now we have to connect the power to the Arduino. So here is the V-in, you have to connect it with the V-in. I've connected the V in to the Arduino, and next we have to make the ground connection. Yes, all the V in and ground is now connected to the Arduino board, and now we have to connect the resistors for the LED. So here is my first resistor. Okay, now I've connected the four resistor to the with the four terminals, and we will connect our LED to their ground to make the connections. Now I have connected all the LEDs. So now my Arduino connections are all perfect here. And let's hook up the power and check the LED presentation of what the data I have entered, it is correct or not. And let's check the program now with the power. I will be rotating my view because I have connected it in inverse order, and it will glow according to this. So let's hook up the power now to check the result. Yeah, now it's perfectly working. As you can see, now it is connecting up. Since my D3 is now connected to nothing, so it is taking that T3 is 0, and since D3 is low, so it is connecting up. So now we will be connecting my switch to so that we can control our D3. Now for the switching purpose, I will be using this jumper wire. Now I will connect it with the terminal D3. Okay, now it is connected. Now I am putting back the Arduino connection. Now with this I will be attaching the 680 ohm resistance to the ground so that it can take the ground connection, and even by chance if there is a short, then it will not be short, and at that time the 680 ohm will act as the resistance between them. So it will prevent my short circuiting. And now we have to connect a push button switch here. And let's connect it to the high connection. So now be controlling this, it will give my high signal, and accordingly it will go back and give my low signal. So now I have completely made the connection on the board, and now let's move it to check the result, because I have connected all the LEDs in reverse order. So now let's hook up the power and check the result. It is perfectly working, and now it is counting up. Now we'll switch on and let's check what is counting down. No, and as you can see, now it is counting down. So now I will be connecting our display module here to check the result more clearly. So now I have connected my display module here, and now as you can see that why I was connecting my ABCD in reverse order, because now this will be very helpful. Now this become A, this become B, this become C, and finally this become D. So that's why I've connected the reverse order, so that I can easily connect it to my display module. And here also I've connected it accordingly to check my result. So now let's put on the power and check the result. Okay, so now as you can see, now it is connecting up, and now I will be switching on my switch and let's check whether it is counting down or not. So now it starts with 9, then 9, 8, 7, it will move like this. So as you can see, now it is counting down. And if I again release my switch, then it will start counting up. So now I will use my old circuit residues where I have connected this with these terminals, and I have made the remained the connection the same way. And here is my power selection. Just I have changed the program to LED chaser circuit to my Arduino. So now I will put my Arduino on the breadboard and let's power it to check the result. So now I will be putting my Arduino and hold it tightly in the board. Okay, now it's tightly on the board. And now I will connect the LEDs. Yeah, I have connected all the LEDs, and now let's check with the power. And here as you can see, we are getting our running LED circuit. So this was my video on the, now it's working properly. That was some, I hope that was something like loose connections. Yeah, now it's working properly. So this was my video on the circuits which I made by using flip-flop in previous videos, and this video I have made that circuits with the help of Arduino, and I have also uploaded the Arduino program in this video. I hope you have already viewed it. So I hope that you like my video. So please like my video and please subscribe my YouTube channel, because I will be uploading more videos on electronics. So that's all for today, and thanks for watching.